Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, Sean Locke, Rod Gilbert, Sarah Pascoe, Johnny Vegas, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, the inventor of the telephone, Alexander Graham Bell, suggested all phone calls begin with the words ahoy hoy, as in the sentence, ahoy hoy, have you been missold PPI? There is an Amazonian tribe that only has three numbers, one, two and many, and even they beat Sean at Countdown. And cats can jump five times their own height, or even more if you've taped a firework to their bum. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, Sean Locke. I'm not saying Sean doesn't smile much, but if he was an ITV period drama, he'd be Frownton Abbey. If he was a leading Hollywood actor, he'd be Robert Frowney Jr. And if he was a book about rabbits, he'd be Watership Frown. It's incredible. And Sean's teammate, Rod Gilbert. Rod is incredibly popular in Wales. Wherever he goes, people stop what they're doing to say hello. It doesn't matter whether they're having sex with their sister, kissing a sheep, or telling their mum how sexy she looks. Everything to say hello to Rod. Up against them this evening, it's John Richardson. When out for dinner, John likes to arrange items like sauce bottles and pepper pots in symmetrical lines on the table. You might think that'd be annoying for the person John's with, but you'll be relieved to hear he's alone. John has bought a house in the Lake District. Dreary, miserable and wet is how his new neighbours describe him. And joining John tonight, it's Sarah Pascoe. Sarah is a feminist, a vegan, and incredibly funny. She's basically the exact opposite of Jeremy Clarkson. Sarah, you've never been on this show before, so I'll just go over the basic rules for you.
Okay.
All the rounds are against the clock.
Yep.
You can't use the same letter twice, and don't get stuck talking to John after the show. He's very boring.
You can use the same letter twice in different rounds. Just to clarify your rules.
I think you're going to really fit in with John. Sean, what's a normal day like in the life of Sean Locke?
It's just 8 hours of sleep, 6 hours of hiding, 2 hours of sort of regret and apologies, hour of scratching, and then a bit of telly to unwind. And it's like, that's basically what it is. I think a lot of people don't know about me. I'm incredibly organised. Like, for example, if I make tea, I don't make one cup of tea. I'll make a big batch of tea. And then I'll have a cup of tea and then I'll freeze the rest of it. And then when I want to have a cup of tea, I'll just break off a bit of frozen tea, put it in a pan. 25 minutes later, I've got a lovely cup of tea without all the hassle. Just little, I just do really organised things like that. But yeah, I'm just organised. Always put a bit of butter on the knife before I go to bed.
Rod, you are one of the strongest Cats Does Countdown players of all time. Are you feeling the pressure to perform this evening?
No, I'm not. I mean, I'm with Sean. Yeah. It's not like I can win from you, is it?
Turn and hooch. The turn this and is hooch like, of Countdown.
You've only got a chance if you're on John's team. You've got no chance with this.
I mean, he's sitting right there.
I know. Yeah, I know, he can't understand me.
Look at the size of him.
Putting me with him is like taking a champion racehorse, sawing off its hooves and replacing them with empty bean tins.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
It's like strapping a cement mixer to a greyhound.
If I did my SATs now, I'd definitely get into year seven.
John, you like to play by the rules. What's the most rebellious thing you've ever done?
No comment. Been watching a lot of 24 Hours in Police Custody, Jimmy. Ask me another question, narc.
It's Sarah's first time on the show. How do you think she's going to do?
No comment.
We can sit here all day and have you say no comment, but we just want to clear this up.
Can I be your solicitor?
Yep.
OK. If you want to speak to my client, you need to get a warrant.
A warrant to speak to him?
We've introduced
I'm not going to enter him.
Against you as being harassing, you want to enter my client.
I didn't say that.
You did say it.
It was no comment.
Sarah, you're genuinely friends with John. Have you ever had any fun with him?
Yeah, loads of fun. John is such a lovely, clever, moralistic person. John is the kind of friend, you know, you have the kind of friend, the really fun one, who you go out with on the pool and they're your wingman and they help you meet people. And John's the kind of guy... John's the kind of guy who tells you that kissing is unhygienic. But everyone needs that in their lives for balance.
Zero STDs.
Okay, John, have you got a mascot this evening?
Sort of, Jimmy. I think there's too much aggression in this programme and I think there's too much competition. I've been on a journey to develop myself. A journey of enlightenment, if you will. I'm wearing my...
Have you had a year off?
They helped me... They helped me. I think the best way I can perform on Countdown is to relax and enjoy myself and... Buddha himself only achieved enlightenment at 35. So if I do it this year, I beat him by 3 years.
And that's what it's about, isn't it, enlightenment?
I'm doing Buddhist phrases, but with a sort of modern twist. Like, faith is nourishment, but only porridge has slow-release carbohydrates. Sort of updating it a bit. Time is an illusion, but lateness is real and rude. I've brought a number of things to just help me centre and relax. Like, I wanted some incense, but you're not allowed to light it indoors. So I've brought an electronic incense that is... it's just a Glade plug-in in a box. But it creates...
What sort of cult do you belong to where they're not allowed to have incense indoors?
The cult of health and safety in a working environment.
Is that bangle on your left arm? Is that part of the costume or is that just you have that on anyway?
That is a Swindon meditation bead. I picked that up at Swindon Market and it just helps me remember that I'm not in Swindon anymore.
Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yes. I bought a lucky rabbit's foot. It's that one there.
It's not that lucky, it's dead.
She died of natural causes. I know that. I've got a certificate that I made. I'm a vegan, so I can't like taxidermy.
I don't think you can die of natural causes and just... Look at it. It was obviously perfectly well.
She died of shock because her husband started going out with one of their children. It's all right with rabbits, but it was still a horrible surprise.
Did you buy that online and you were expecting something else? OK, Sean, what's your mascot?
You know, people, they don't want to buy people, they buy people things like aprons, like funny aprons. And I've seen a gap in the market, and I thought, well, what about sort of sad aprons? Or even better, slightly disturbing aprons. So I've come up with this one. As you see here, it's got a...
Beautifully made.
What's going on this apron? Well, there's an empty bird's nest. And then in the oven gloves, what have we got here? Oh! It's a little baby bird on his back. Has he fallen from the nest? That's the little baby bird. Ah! Oh, and what's on this oven glove? It's a hungry cat. And what's the hungry cat going to do? He's going to get the baby bird. That's my new range.
Okay, Rod, have you got a mascot?
I've got my choir with me. all Welsh people, Jimmy, have a choir. I've got my choir. This is my choir. I normally keep them under the desk or in the dressing room or whatever, and I thought tonight I'd bring them out as a little mascot. They just cheer me up, they cheer me on, they bit of motivational singing sometimes. If I'm feeling down, they'll give me a little lift.
Well, how are you feeling at the moment?
I'm feeling all right. You can give me a little motivational ditty if you want, lads. Take it away.
Do, it's coming home. It's coming. Countdown's coming home. 2 a.m. It's coming home. It's coming. Countdown's coming home.
I want to know which one in the choir is the deep voice one, because it's never the one you expect.
Carl.
Is it you?
Yeah.
It's not me.
It's you.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Johnny Vegas. Johnny appeared in the film The Libertine opposite Johnny Depp. Now, I've not seen it, but I'm guessing it's not about a man who finds his long-lost twin. Johnny, apart from appearing in Dictionary Corner, what else is on your bucket list?
I'd like to walk with dolphins. Because I'd like to think there's some posh dolphins somewhere that want to walk with Johnny Vegas. Or at the very least go on one of them, you know, the mobility scooters. I'd like to sit next to a pretty lady without chomping constantly. I'd like to be thin. But not for too long. I'd like to go back to being thin and then ruin it all over again. I'd like to be able to swap my legs with my arms. and then go swimming but not be quite sure which direction I should be going in. My bucket list is endless. I'd like a bucket. A nice one.
OK, and with Johnny, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie, have you got any pre-show rituals?
Well, Rachel and I have a Cats Down version of Snog, Marry, Kill for you, John and Sean.
Well, I would like the results, please.
Well, there's two kills and one snog.
Well, no, you've got... Well, Snog, Marry, Kill, you've got a...
I think we're dead, Jimmy.
All right, in charge of numbers, Rachel Riley. Rachel says she loves a man who's good at working out. Well, Rachel, if you mean maths, I'm not your man. But if you mean going down the gym and pumping iron, then I'm still not your man. Rachel, what advice would you give to any wannabe mathematicians watching?
Well, there's loads of stuff you can study to do with maths that's not just numbers. So recently I went to Everton's training ground to see how they use maths there to make the players better.
Well, like score more goals than the other team.
Oh, like get your heart rate up and just lots of different things that they're measuring. And someone else that
Sorry, Everton invited you to their changing room to watch them measure stuff.
Not their changing room, but their training ground.
Their training ground. So what were they measuring?
Well, technology. They were measuring heart rate.
Do you mean like algorithms?
No.
What's you? Just trying to meet you halfway.
Okay, tonight the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown Bubble Bath. Oh, this is the saddest thing we've ever asked him to do. Okay, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. Sean and Rod, you get the first pick of the letters.
Vowel, please.
Thank you, Sean. I.
Consonant.
C.
Dead people.
consonant, please.
B.
Consonant.
S. I see B.
Vowel.
U.
Another vowel.
E.
Consonant.
D.
Ooh, I think another consonant.
N.
Yes.
Ooh. Oh. What do you reckon, vowel or consonant?
Couldn't give a shit.
We'll have another consonant, please.
And the last one, S.
And for the first time today, your time starts now.
Seven.
Seven. OK. John, what have you got?
Seven.
Ooh, two sevens. Yeah, we've done well. Sarah, what have you got?
Six.
Six. Rod?
Eight.
Really?
Yeah.
Good boy.
Eight. Well, that does not bode well for the numbers round, but OK. Sarah, what's your six?
Cubics.
Cubics?
Yeah. No, I can't do that. I've used the C twice. I've already got it wrong. That was the first rule you told me.
Okay, so
just sentence.
All right, you're right. Oh.
I deserved it. I deserved that.
Okay. Sean, your what was
induces.
Yours? Induces. John, you're seven.
It's incense. I know the letters aren't there, but this stuff's sending me high, and I can't.
I've made you have a little lie down. Rod, you're right.
Suddenly. But I did have to bend the rules a bit. I spelled it S-U-D-N-I, suddenly. Suddenly.
You're a bit fussy about that on this show.
Is it?
Yeah, but not having L's and things, they do. It's just one of those real... It's a real pisser.
Yeah.
Especially when you've got a good word like suddenly.
Well, Sean's the only one with a word, so 7 points to Sean. Vegas, could they have done any better?
Yeah, we got a seven and a six. You could have had subside. Ooh. You could have had undies for six.
How do you actually do it with that dictionary then? Because I never look up when you're doing it, but you just literally flick through it all like I was going through your shit.
How do you do it? Well, you come up with your words, and then I try and guess what you guys might come up with, so I look for those to see whether I can allow those.
All in the 30 seconds?
I have been doing it for a long time.
What was Johnny doing while you were doing that?
He did some really nice drawings, in fact.
Don't blame him!
He's trying to look busy.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Rod are in the lead with seven. Rod, how are you feeling about that? Your team got the points.
Well, I think we got the points there because they, Jimmy, are shit at words, aren't they, lads?
They're shit at words and they know they are. Shit at words and they know they are. Word-wise, they're a load of shit. They're a proper, illiterate, wordy shit.
That's why you got the points, you think, yeah.
I think I'm going to be sick. I'm going to turn this off.
Are you genuinely getting high off your incense?
I don't do drugs, so if I want to get high, I skip a meal and have a hot bath.
Literally the saddest man in Britain. OK, on to our first numbers round. OK, John and Sarah, your turn to pick the numbers.
Four small ones and then two big ones.
Thank you, Sarah. And for this round, the small ones are 6, 2, 9 and 8 and the big ones, 75 and 50. And the target, 589.
OK, and your time starts now.
Thank you.
OK, so the target was 589.
Oh, because if we got it right...
Did you get it right, Sean?
Yeah!
Rod, did you get it right?
Yes.
Sarah, did you get it right?
No, I'm one off.
OK, John, what have you got?
589.
You've got 589. OK, right. So, Sean, you seem particularly confident.
I just said 75 and 600. And then you just added the 9 and the 2, you say, well, you can 589. Yeah!
Well done. John, is that how you did it?
I did it a similar way, but without the mental breakdown.
Good maintaining a level of dignity throughout.
Yeah, well, no, sort of. Look at the way I'm fucking dressed.
OK, so 10 points to both teams. OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner for the first time today. Johnny, what have you got for us?
What I've got, Jimmy, is a bit of potter there.
Ooh.
I'm not happy with you dumbing down the teapot and making it a novelty prize. It's a practical object that a lot of potters make and their livelihood depends on it. Now, I know that's ironic, seeing as I peddle tea bags for a living, but I thought I would get over there on the wheel and make a trophy. Is
get that all get right to with it. You? Fabulous. Yeah, great idea. You look as if you're on the shittest fairground ride ever.
Now, what I'm sure you've already guessed, Jimmy, I've already pre-centred the clay.
Gotcha.
Because we haven't got all night.
No.
You know what I mean? And I'm not somebody who likes to indulge myself on these kind of shows. I'm going to make a trophy.
Okay.
A trophy that will be obviously handed to the winners.
Oh. Where's that moisture coming from?
Where do you think? I only ever throw with my own sweat.
Do you know what this now looks like, a class in a public school? It looks like the poshest school in the world and they've brought one working class boy in to see what it's like.
So, I'm gonna... Just very quickly, very simply... What's so funny about that?
You look like you've tried to clear a gymnastics horse, got stuck on the top and just thought I might as well make the best of it.
It's a tricky bit. No, well, I'm raising it up now, you see, and the pot, all it's trying to do, Jimmy, is get away. And the trick is to showboat, you know, to push it out wide, but no, I'm going to take it in. I'm take it, almost like it's going to have a lid. Then, bring it up the main body! So I want you to rise! I want that boy that does the maths to know I have gifts! Even though you're a wonderful person. Right, now I've got to make the handles quick. You may want to help me out here. Grab one. Squeeze it. Work it. That's it, into a shape. Now come over here. Come to Papa. Too quick. Just work it. Work it. That's... Yeah, that ain't good, innit? Right, work mine. Just that's it. That's nice. Right, now I'm going to trust you to start the second one. Remember what I've taught you? Go on, that's it, that's it. Yeah, a bit of water, a bit of water. Come on, love. Yeah, no, look what you've done to the end. Seriously. Jesus Christ, man, it's pottery, not porn. Just sit down. Right, and then we just... Somebody will win that.
Nice. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Vegas! So the scores at the moment, Sean and Rod are on 17, John and Sarah are on 10. And here is your teaser. The words are nice dong, and the clue is nerds can't get enough of it. That's nice dong, nerds can't get enough of it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were nice dong. The clue was nerds can't get enough of it. It was, of course, in coding. So, Sean and Rod are in the lead. Time to mix things up a little bit, I think. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sarah and Sean. So, Sarah, your turn to choose the letters.
OK. Can I have a vowel, please?
Thank you, Sarah.
And then another vowel.
E. And then I.
And then a consonant.
And then L.
And then another consonant.
T.
And then a vowel.
O.
And then a consonant.
N.
And then a consonant.
M.
Then a vowel.
E.
And then a vowel.
And the last one. A.
OK, and your time starts now. I haven't got a gag reflex. Sarah, how many did you get?
Five.
OK, Sean?
Six.
And Sarah, you're five?
Lemon.
Lemon. Sean, you got six. Which six did you get?
Entail.
Ooh, lovely. Ooh. I also got Milton, but that's a person's name and a place. But that's, is there any extra points for knowing Milton?
I'll have a quick check. No. So 6 points to Sean. Could they have done any better? Johnny?
Of course he could.
Yeah, no, you're right. You're absolutely right, Dictionary Corner. They could have done better.
We've got sevens across the board.
What sevens have you got, Susie?
Ailment, toenail.
and oatmeal.
You didn't get oatmeal. Forget oatmeal.
Okay. Forget oatmeal.
Susie, you wrote it down now. I look like an idiot.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Rod have 23 points, John and Sarah have just 10. Right, time now for the match-up you've all been waiting for. Rod and John are going to go head-to-head.
Because we need the points in order to help me focus and clear my mind for this, the Chinese eat a lot of tiger penis to help them focus, but I don't eat meat. So what I've done is I've made a carrot smoothie. But I've only used carrots that look like they've got dicks. That's sort of carrot dick smoothie. I'm sure we'll have the same effect. But no tigers were harmed.
Okay, down in one. Come on, down in one. You could do this.
I could do this, but I don't need to prove anything to you. Oh, nearly did it then as well. I'm my own man. Aren't I, John? Yeah, you are, mate.
OK. Rod, your turn to pick the numbers.
Two from the top and four from everyone else.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Two big ones, four little ones.
Thank you.
And these ones are 2, 3, 2, 8. And the big one, 75 and 50. And the target, 436.
OK, your time starts now. So the target was 436. Rod, did you get it?
I mean, I don't know if this is a countdown first, but I'm 0.5 out.
Wow! So what have you got?
I've got 437.5.
So you're 1.5 out.
Oh, hang on. 2 into 75 is 30.
You can't do that.
34.
You can't do division.
But you can't division. I'll start again. I haven't done division.
You can't divide and get fractions, can you?
You're not allowed fractions.
OK, John, did you get it?
Yeah.
How did you do it?
50 plus 2 plus 2.
50 plus the 2 2s, 54.
Times 8.
Times 8 is 432.
And let's all take a moment to check our sums.
So I can't do do. So I can't do 50 times 8 is. Why can't I do 50 times 8 is 400?
50 times 8
right,
is
and then
400.
You get the 3 and the 2 and you take them from the 75, which is 70. You divide that by 2. Why can't I do that?
You can do that.
You can do
I can
that.
Do that.
Yeah, you can't do 75.
But if you do that, yeah.
You can do that. 75 minus 3, 72, divide that by 2, but not the 75.
Yeah, that, there.
Yeah, that's there what you wanted to do.
Yeah, that's that what you should have done, but you didn't.
Well, you didn't. I pretty much did.
No one's getting the points there. You've got to declare it correctly in order to get the points. I don't know how you're feeling now, Rod. How are you feeling now? And I don't want you to tell me. I want them to tell me.
Take it away, lads. Slam him.
My old man's a dustman. He wears a dustman's hat. Rod Gilbert is a Countdown star and Jimmy is a twat.
Cool. You don't take on the choir, pal.
Apologies. OK, so Sean and Rod have 23 points. John and Sarah have just 10 still. OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Johnny, what have you got for us?
What I've got is something developing here. I've made a prototype.
I love it.
It's... yeah, it's my head.
I'm guessing this is for when you're elected Supreme Leader.
Jimmy, it has a multitude of uses. And, also,
it's primarily used to weird out Sean.
No, no. I don't like people who buy council houses and put them lions up. So I'm combating that, but I'm going to have two of these either side of my gatepost. Just so people know who they're fucking dealing with.
Does it function as a hat? Johnny, could you wear it as a...
It can't. Yeah, there's no point me wearing it, is it? It just looks like I'm allergic to seafood. If I... It is good to go to the doctors and go, what the...
It looks... don't take it off.
When you're at an awards ceremony and you've lost and you just want to look impassive. But, I don't know. I don't know a home that wouldn't want one.
That is magnificent, Johnny.
Look, it's something nice. It's a work of art. If anybody wants one, give us a call.
Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Vegas. The scores at the moment, Sean and Rod are on 23, John and Sarah are on 10. And here is your teaser. The words are taste poo, and the clue is, I like mine mashed. That's taste poo, I like mine mashed. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were taste poo, the clue was, I like mine mashed. It was, of course, potatoes. OK, before we go on, it's time to give Rachel a special assistant. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Joey Essex.
I want this rolling on a Rolls Royce, not this, but they didn't have it. Get me?
That's just as good, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Joey Essex there. Yeah. Ben. How are you tonight, Joey? You well?
Yeah, I'm right, yeah.
It's very nice to have you back on Countdown. You pleased to be back?
Yeah, I'm well glad. I mean, I only done it once, didn't I?
Yes, you were here once and now you're back.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
And I was saying, is it nice to be back?
Oh, it's brilliant. I love it, yeah.
Joey, do you think you're going to make a good assistant for Rachel?
I think so, but I don't really know, I'm not, that clever at, getting words right and all that.
Well, that's OK. You know the difference between a vowel and a consonant, don't you?
No, not really. No, honestly, I really don't.
A vowel's a doing word.
I don't get that either. I bet you any money, someone in this audience does not know what a vowel consonant is.
Okay.
I know it's a letter.
Yeah.
Well, you're halfway bloody there. have a little sit down. This is only a formality, really. But to be Rachel's assistant, you have to pass a small test. I've got a couple of questions for you. Your time starts now. One of the rules in Essex is no carbs before marbs. How do you spell Marbella?
M-A-R-B-E-L-E, no, L-L-A.
Near enough, yes. Correct. Gary, what is a word for a baby kangaroo?
Joey.
The right answer. And a cheeky wink that was very nice. what do you put in a toaster?
Toast. Bread.
Bread. You got there on
Trick
your
question.
Own. Who's your father's sister?
My dad ain't got a sister.
Absolutely good enough. We've had no other applicants. That will do. You can be Rachel's assistant. Come on, Rachel and Joey, together you look like Ken and Barbie.
No way.
Thank you, Jeremy.
You've not taken that as well as Joey. Joey's chuffed a bit with that. He's modelled himself on him. OK, on with the game. Sean and Rod, your turn to choose the letters.
OK. Have a vowel, please, Joey.
Oh, well, he does say vowel, it's pretty easy. Yeah. I know a vowel is definitely an E.
And a consonant, please.
All right, we'll just go along the bottom. W.
Can you do some, Rob?
Yeah, I'll do one. Vowel, please, Joey. Oh, you're right, it's good fun.
It's
no,
fun,
you do, you
it's good fun.
What was an N?
Consonant, please, Joey.
That's an N.
Vowel, please, Joey.
Oh, this is great. An assistant that actually does something.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's very good.
Do you know what? I've never, ever got this game, ever.
You know...
I've been on it before and I've watched it before, but I've never got it.
Joey?
But I don't know what the game is.
You know you're on it now, don't you? There's a crowd over there.
You'll get the hang of it. Rachel, we'll talk you through this. You've just got to find a word within these letters.
Oh, I've got to find a word.
No, let's walk before we can run.
And a consonant.
Another consonant, please, Joey.
How do you know what one to pick?
Well, it's just random, really.
Well, I would have chosen a vowel. I don't know why.
Vowel. Let's just have a vowel.
If you'd have gone for a vowel,
go for a vowel. Go for a vowel.
Yeah.
Essex. See. Well, if I was you, I'd choose a consonant because you just chose a vowel.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah. Thank you.
H.
Okay, and your time starts now. Okay, Joey, let's go to you first. What have you got?
Nose.
Nose? Like nose is there.
Yeah. Pretty obvious. It's like N-O-S-E. It's like, well, nose.
You're killing it. You're absolutely killing it. Okay. Four. That's not terrible. Okay. John, how many you got?
Seven.
Seven, okay. Sarah?
Six.
Rod?
Six.
Sean?
Six.
OK, well, let's hear the sixes. Sarah?
Resown, as in R-E-S-O-W-N.
Well, you're into that.
Yeah, yeah, you stick resown up. There's another way to do it would be to do it above.
It's not there.
OK, Rod, what have you got?
Worsen.
Ooh,
worsen.
Very good. Oh. There's worsen in there.
Very good, yeah. I like that one.
Sean?
Ensure.
Ensure. What's your seven, John?
Rehouse.
Oh, Rehouse.
Very yeah. good.
Yeah. Rehouse.
Sure.
7 points to John.
Good.
Johnny, Susie, could they have done any better?
Nowhere as well. That's
There's nowhere.
Nowhere.
Nowhere. Tremendous. So at the end of that, Sean and Rod are in the lead with 23. And here is your final teaser. The words are Rod Tugs, and the clue is there's barely a trickle. That's Rod Tugs, there's barely a trickle. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were rod tugs. The clue was there's barely a trickle. It was, of course, droughts. Now, Joey, you're known for your fashion sense. You're something of a trendsetter, aren't you?
Yeah, you can say that.
Well, talk us through some of your looks. What were you thinking there? Were you thinking I'd like my boots to match my teeth?
No, I just got them boots and I was going to an ice skating rink and I thought, I'm going to wear some, like, boots that match the ice.
What else we got?
Strong. Strong. Wow. Now, to promote my girls' fragrance and boys' fragrance, obviously the girls' one's pink and the boys' one's black, because I thought I'd wear pink and black.
Did you have that specially made?
Yeah.
What happened to the suit?
It's in my closet.
Well, when you get that Bassett's licorice job.
Amazing. So the half pink suit is in the closet, is it?
Yes.
Okay, and then we've got another look. Look at this. I mean, that is Ken from Ken and Barbie, isn't it?
It's not that dissimilar from yours.
What do you mean from mine?
It's kind of got like the parting and the black and the people in glass houses.
Okay, time for our final letters game. John and Sarah, your turn to choose.
Right, okay, you do it this time because I did it last time.
We'll have a consonant, please.
M.
A vowel, please. Consonant, please.
N.
A vowel, please.
Maybe we should put a bit of pressure on you, time pressure on you picking them. Why don't we hear... Because these guys can do a countdown clock while you're picking them.
Oh, yeah, go on. Countdown clock. Come on, pick your letters.
Consonant, please.
S.
Consonant.
K. Hey.
Vowel, please. Vowel, please.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Bills. And your time starts now. Joey, come over here. John, what have you got?
Seven.
Sean, what have you got?
Nothing.
Rod, what have you got?
Nine.
Sarah?
I've got five. I'm really bad at this. I really had high expectations for myself.
Nice, isn't it?
Yeah. Sarah, what's your five?
Makes.
Makes. OK. I think Joey could have got that.
Easy.
Too easy, says Joey. John?
Pinkies.
Pinkies? Ooh. Ooh.
Go
and
again.
Rod, your nine-letter word.
I've made a terrible error.
What did you have? What did you think you...
I had miniscappy.
It's worth a punt. Is it in there, Susie?
I'm going to take a gamble here and go...
OK, so 7 points to John's team there. I think Rachel needs you, Joey. So, Dictionary Corner, could they have done any better?
You could have also had Pie Man for six.
I love that.
Pie Man.
We have Pinkies and Pie Man.
Pinkies and Pie Man. OK, so Sean and Rod have 23, John and Sarah have 24. Fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. Your time starts now.
Promenade.
Oh, he's got it.
Promenade after 3 seconds. Let's see if he's right.
Oh, got it.
Oh. Wow.
So the final scores are Rod and Sean have 23, John and Sarah have 34. They're tonight's winners. Congratulations, John and Sarah. You're now the proud owners of this countdown bubble bar. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
more cats doing Countdown next Friday at the same time. A frolic through the memory banks on Sunday night, James McAvoy stars in The British Inception, Danny Boyle's Trance at 9. Settling down for some banter and a grown-up beverage next, although you might opt for a cup of tea. Each to their own. Chatty Man is next.